If you recall, during our last budget vote, we committed to South Africa that we are going to bring change to the industry. And it started with us providing skills to those that are unskilled. Therefore, we partnered with MICTC, who then contracted ages to make sure that we make it a reality and therefore let it be practical. Therefore, identification of young people throughout the provinces that were identified, there was the three provinces that were agreed on pilot was Eastern Cape, Gauteng, and Western Cape. Eastern Cape, because of its vastness, got to get a bigger number. Therefore, 70 students are coming from this province. And we are here today with the 68 students. Unfortunately, two have already dropped. But the 68 that is here is promising that they will stick with the program until the end of it. But most importantly, ours is to say, how do we then tap into the opportunities that are being presented by the industry? Others, they just want to go there and represent us, but we are saying let's unpack the entire value chain and exploit it thereof. Therefore, that is why we have them here. They are busy with film and television production. Now be ready to hear the stories of the Eastern Cape and the communities where they come from. Everybody from Gauteng, from the Western Cape, they are coming to the Eastern Cape. They have realized that the stories of Eastern Cape have not been told. That is why they're coming here. They have seen that Eastern Cape is the fashionable thing now. But what we are saying is that people of the Eastern Cape, you cannot fold arms and all you do is to be viewers of whatever programs that are being broadcasted. Tap into that market. Make sure that you tell your stories as you know them.
Since the President delivered the State of the Nation address, we've been crisscrossing the country to create a dialogue or a platform for a dialogue between citizens and government.
What does economic freedom entail? President Zuma dealt with that in his State of the Nation address. He gave a detailed explanation outlining the program on the 9-point plan. Realizing that 21 years down the line, you have walked this path because other people have fought for it. Hence, today we're talking of a democratic South Africa. And when President outlines his program, he therefore gives you an opportunity to say, Nam ndizokwenza umahluko.